Hello there, this is Lynn Allen. Thank you for joining me for another AutoCAD tip courtesy of the fabulous Cadalyst magazine. Hope you're having a great week so far. So far, so good for me, which makes me happy. Today I'm going to share with you a tip that has to do with the Lengthen command, which is a command that I find that a lot of people either don't know about it, or they're not using it, or they forgot about it, and it is actually a very handy command. Today we're gonna focus on lengthening lines, and if you're good, we'll come back and we'll take a look at arcs later. All right, so you can type in the lengthen command, or you can behave yourself. You can go to the ribbon, and you can click on the modify panel of the home tab of the ribbon, and there, right there, is the lengthen command. All right, so very simple command. One of the nice things about the lengthen command is it will tell you very quickly how long an object is. You can see right there, it told me the current length is 15. All right, well, maybe that's not what I want. Maybe I want to tell it the total length. I wish the total length was, say, 22. All right, and then you can go ahead and click whichever objects you want to be 22 units in length. Notice that it matters which end you go on, right? Which endpoint is gonna determine which side it is lengthened, or it could be just made shorter as well. So lengthen also will make an object shorter, which is slightly counterintuitive. Okay, so that was easy enough, right? So let's go back into the lengthen command and we'll select this line again. Once again, it tells us it's, now we know it's 22. It really, really did work. Let's try delta. So delta is how much longer you want the object to be. In this case, it will always lengthen it, all right? So let's say I want it to be 5 units longer, and it's very visual. Once again, whichever end you select is the end that it will make longer, that it will lengthen. Pretty straightforward, very visual on the screen. All right, let's go back in. And this time we're going to do percent. All right, so let's say I want my object to be 25% of the length that it used to be. And you can make it longer, you can say 150%, or you can make it shorter. I'm gonna say 25. All right, so now as I move my cursor around, you will see now the end that I select is the end in this case is gonna be cut off. And it's gonna give me 25% of the total length. I'm only gonna get the other side of that line. So you can see the same deal. Kind of interesting. And once again, you can make it longer by giving it a value higher than 100%. Okay, and if you make a mistake, of course, you can undo while you're in the command. Very, very simple, very straightforward. Okay, the last option, we did delta, we did percent, we did total, is dynamic. Now, to be honest, dynamic, not really my favorite. To me, it's easier to do this with grips, using the multi-function grips, but you know, whatever works for you. I'm gonna go ahead and you'll see I'm gonna select this object and it tells me now it's only gonna lengthen it in the same direction. You should know that. Even if I turn my ortho off, it's not gonna make any difference. It's gonna lengthen the line, keeping the angle the same. All right, so as I move my cursor, you can see it's telling me the distance it's lengthening it or shortening it, depending on where you go. And you could type in a value if you want to. I'm gonna go ahead and just select. All right, that one's not so exciting. But nevertheless, you will see that if I go back in the length command, some pretty cool options in there to help you very quickly lengthen or sometimes shorten an object, okay, depending on what you're doing. So I hope that you found that tip to be valuable, and we'll take a look at arcs later on, and I'm gonna see you back here in 2 more weeks, all right? Take care, behave.